So we know you've been on the front lines of this crisis. So first of all, thank you so much for everything that you're trying to do to help with all of this. If you had a crystal ball, what would be a few of your predictions for our future in our world? Any thoughts on that?
Yeah, that's a great question. And a lot of folks are contending with that. First of all, it's really been the nurses and the healthcare workers and the doctors who have been at the front line of this. They really have been the soldiers at the front line. And I think that analogy is correct in my opinion. And they have also borne the brunt of this disease. A pretty high percentage of the healthcare of the people who have perished because of this disease have been health workers. And I have the greatest of the respects for them. And a lot of my colleagues at Stanford Biodesign and Stanford Global Health have been part of that, and I have a lot of greatest of respect for them. The effect of this disease is so extensive. This is, once in a 100-year kind of phenomenon, and it has impacted more countries and territories than there are members of the UN. 210 plus countries and territories have been impacted by this. It affects the rich and the poor and old and the young, even though it was believed originally that young don't get as impacted by it. I think there's growing evidence that young kids can also be impacted by this. It has impacted the most vulnerable the most, whether you have had comorbidities, heart disease, lung disease, diabetes, you are at a high risk, cancer, something that has affected your immune system. But it has also impacted the broader part of the population, our students, our high school students and the primary school students and the college students. It has impacted our professionals who go to work. So I think the impact of this disease on what kind of future we have on the other end of this crisis, if there is another end of the crisis, and I believe there is, I think this is going to look very different. The way our social models are going to change, the way we interact with each other has already changed, but I think that's going to sustain. A lot of that is going to sustain in the future. Our how we work is going to change. Our future work, Twitter has already announced that its workforce can work from home forever. I believe there's going to be a hybrid model where folks will come to work where they have to, but a lot of folks will choose to actually blend work from home and work from office and going forward. And a remarkable thing is it's not just going to be in the tech industry, it's probably going to be outside of the tech industry, and it's going to be global. There is going to be new models for healthcare. I think a key challenge has been being able to see patients in light of this crisis. Patients have been worried about coming into the hospital. There is an inverted U-shaped curve in the healthcare system, where in the 30s and 40s, most of the care was provided at home and in the near home. There's a strong belief among the healthcare professionals that I think we are going to go back to that, and new technology is going to play a role in that. A big impact is going to be on local policy making. I think a lot of what you've seen in COVID-19 in this crisis is that a lot of decision making has been local. Bay Area, six counties in the Bay Area were the first in the nation to declare stringent shelter at home guidelines, and that protected this area from outcomes like the ones that we saw in New York. So there's going to be a lot of desire to manage future crises locally, with local decision making and local resources. Another impact that we're going to see is in terms of our supply chain, our manufacturing. It's going to be much more distributed and much more localized. I think some of that is going to be good for the society, because we're going to have a lot more local focus, and maybe artisans are going to get more support and more encouragement as a result of this. But it will mean that maybe costs will go up, and there may be redundancy in our society in terms of the capacity. So we don't know what the future is exactly going to be, but we are starting to see some of these trends emerge, and I think the future is going to look very different. The new normal is going to be actually new. That's what a lot of us believe.